On March 23rd, 2020, the UK went into lockdown to curb the merciless march of coronavirus. We were told to stay home, to stay apart, so we could stay alive. We complied. We ceded personal freedoms we thought were our unassailable rights days before. Driven by fear, responsibility, self-interest, and altruism, we packed up our lives and hunkered down. The impact was profound, swarming into every crevice of our lives. There was no respite, no havens, little solace. We became chimeras of clarity and uncertainty. What we must not do today was clear, but for how long? And how should we rewrite our rubrics to fit lockdown life? My path seemed clear. I would put away my music and use my medical and science skills to be as helpful as possible. It was no sacrifice. It was not the time for my kind of art. I'm not a chronicler of the current, and in lockdown there was only today. Perhaps in a year or two I might write about how the fabric of humanity had been altered or not altered. It was the sort of thing I wondered about. That is not what happened. Words, thoughts, emotions, lyrics, melodies swirled inside me. I became a random song generator, a musical juicer, mental scraps transforming into harmonic sludges of dubious merit. It was exhausting, confusing, disorientating. I slept poorly. I couldn't concentrate. I needed to calm down. When I need to calm down, I write and I seek structure. I find comfort in structure when stranded in chaos I can't control. So this project was born. First as a way of coping with the chaos, then as a way of creating something from it. Some upside. I decided to write 4 songs over 2 months from the start of lockdown. Each song would be birthed on a single day from the mood of that day to capture the ephemeral present before it was contorted to rationalize the past and future. A real-time musical journal of life in lockdown. Largesse from the pain of separation to ease the pain of separation. A small way to be together.